Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Solo Queue Silliness here on the channel. Welcome to your first look at Blaze, the brand new tank class hero that was just released today. Now, I do have to say a couple things really fast. First off, the reason why this video is coming up so late today is because I was on the co-optional podcast with Mathis, Jesse, and Dodger, and that's the bulk of the reason why. You also saw I had an early Isaac video today as opposed to being flip-flop with Solo Queue Silliness. Yeah, so that's the reason why. But Blazes out. I am actually not solo queued this time around. I am duo queued with Kate, lovely Momo, also known as Mrs. Northern Lion. You can find her links down below. She's going to be trying out Alexstrasza. I believe this is her second game ever, so looking forward to that. On our team day, it's going to be Blaze, Alexstrasza, Nova, Nazebo, and Dahaka going up against a hard 5 stack. Lieutenant Morales, Muradin, Zagara, Sardin Hammer, and Blaze. Pretty much the worst kind of hard 5 stack to go up against, but luckily we are on a two-lane map, meaning that I have no doubt that if this were a three-lane map, we would have probably already lost. But right now, we do have a fighting chance, I hope anyway. So, going over the abilities really quickly for Blaze, and just as a PSA, I have not played any of Blaze at all. I did not test him on the PTR. I only watched the YouTube video of the Hero Spotlight, and that's about it. So I'm going to go ahead and give you the once-over for all the abilities, as well as the active-passive trait that Blaze has. So his trait's going to be Pyromania, which is going to give him 25 armor, which will reduce the amount of incoming damage by 25%, and also going to deal a moderate amount of damage, 42 damage per tick every half second for 4 seconds, which is not too bad for like wave clearing and stuff. His Q ability is going to be Flamestream. Flamestream is just basically going to be a frontal cone ability that will also go in hand-in-hand in conjunction with Oil Spill, his W ability. Sort of think of it like Keg Toss and it's sort of like Keg Toss and Breath of Fire, like you see right there. And his E ability is going to be Jet Propulsion, which is going to allow me to sort of charge forward. It doesn't collide with creep, but it does collide with enemy heroes and give them a short little stun, which is pretty neat. Sort of like that stun right there that the enemy team Blaze would have. Level 1, let's see, Adrenaline Stim Pack, increase attack speed, movement speed, activate to gain a shield, or Neural Stim Pack to reduce the cooldown. Let's go with the shield, I like that. So that's going to give me a shield for 5 seconds. That sounds pretty good. I'm going to go on in here, and I'm going to activate the shield as well. There's a follow-up stun by the enemy team's Blaze and Sardin Hammer. Unfortunately, we're not able to get a kill here. I'm going to jump into the abundance of Kate. Don't take that out of contents, by the way. Or context, not contents. Look, just don't even pay attention to what I'm saying. Yeah, so his Jet Propulsion, as you see there, it does stun enemy heroes. I believe that's an AoE stun as well. So if they're grouped up, I'll be able to stun basically all of them. Now, what I will say from what I've seen in the try mode, whenever I was messing around before queuing, because I knew queues were just going to be even hours after Blaze's release were just going to be outrageous. The oil spill mechanic seems to be a little bit difficult to. Let's put it this way, the range that you're able to get, that you're able to use the oil spill stuff, is pretty. It's further than you think that you could throw it, like the cast radius, but the way that it reaches is not exactly intuitive. It's a little bit difficult to aim, like, I don't know, I guess you would expect the slick to be a little bit longer than what it is. Yeah, we're going to need some help down here, team. I cannot do anything against Blaze and Sardin Hammer. There we go. I was able to get. I'm gonna activate my shield. Apparently, this Blaze also activated the shield here, but I was able to get Pyromania down. So Kate gonna go in Dragon Queen form. Thank you, Kate. Let's see. Level 4, feeding the flame, adhesive petroleum, oil dispersal, or meltdown reduces. Reduces the damage dealt by 5% up to 30%. Yeah, let's try that. Let's try meltdown. I have Lieutenant Morales over here now. So every time I use my Pyromania trait, that's going to reduce the amount of damage done by anything that I touch up to 30% for a little while, which is pretty neat. Gonna go in and charge Sardin Hammer here, although here comes Blaze. I'm gonna have to activate the shield here because I'm not gonna be able to stick around for abundance. And so right there is a little bit what I was talking about. It's kind of wonky with the way that the W works. Basically just because of the fact that you're not able to. It sort of curves like a Kel'Thuzad Zod in a way. I'm actually going to go ahead and stun, or not stun, but go after Lieutenant Morales. I was hoping to stun her. I am going to activate Pyromania here. Again, going after Lieutenant Morales should be the main focus of anything that we're doing. See if we can go help out Kate a little bit. Kate, you gotta run, Kate. Yeah, I was able to peel for Kate here. I don't think I'm gonna be able to catch up to Blaze, however. While Murden is still up top. Yeah, so there's the AoE stun you're able to get. I'm gonna go ahead and use my shielding, my endurance stim pack here as well. Be careful of Zagara. And after 4 minutes, it's 3-3 so far. There we go. Just get a little bit of healing done. I mean, we're not going to be doing much damage to the enemy team's immortal. Not without Nazebo, anyway. Yeah, so I was able to get the oil slick there ignited, and yeah, we're actually doing a fair bit amount of damage to him. Down goes Blaze. I'm going to go ahead and go after a Sergeant Hammer here. Actually, I was able to get the stun on Lieutenant Morales. Gonna go ahead and pop my Pyromania as well. Remember, I'm reducing the amount of damage done by anything that's around me and getting hit for that pulsing. I am gonna have to back up though. I'm sort of liking that shield, that endurance shield that I get. But there is a pretty good chance that we are not gonna be able to get the immortal, especially after I get stunned there, so. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and back on up here. Right now, the hard 5 stack taking the lead just by a little bit. I'm a little bit concerned that I'm number one on XP soaking, even though I've been, I've not really been doing much in the lane. We're gonna have to go ahead and stop that. So far, I mean, Blaze feels like it's like a combination of, D.Va in a way, because of jet propulsion, and also Chen. Let's see, Crossfire can deal bonus damage. Increase the duration, ignite duration. Oh, we gotta do that. Grill and kill, I like that. I like the sound of that. Heard me getting the pings there for the quest. Fortunately, I don't. Kate might be able to get out of there. Yeah, Kate's good. I actually lost myself in all this madness. I'm gonna go ahead and activate Pyromania as well. Remember, I'm reducing the amount of damage done by anything that my trait touches. I'm trying to get the ignite out. There we go, doing a lot of damage to Sergeant Hammer. Of course, I do not have my endurance charge up quite yet for the stim pack. And we're just going to go have to walk out of here and hope that we can hold him at this fort. There we go, getting a lot of pings there for my quest. Good lord. Nazebo. Unfortunately, Nazebo he overestimated his survivability just a little bit too much, but this is sort of the downside here of going up against a bunch of specialists, which I was sort of scared about. And this is only on a two-lane map. We have to get someone to get into the back line to stop a Sergeant Hammer, which I realize is part of my job, but I also can't really I can't do everything. All right. Well, at least you tried, Nazebo. After 7 minutes, now it's 4-7. And again, inexplicably, I'm number one on XP. Gonna head on down to the bottom. Have we taken down a turret? No. Have we taken down a gate? No. Alright. Alright, we're doing well, team. I actually got knocked away there by the displacement grenade of Lieutenant Morales, and we're just gonna lose another fort. We really need our Nazebo to not be taking a camp right now. Nazebo needs to be, like, stopping us from losing our keep here. So we all get stunned here. I'm going to activate Pyromania, and then I'm going to get immediately trapped in the zombie wall by Nazebo. But hey, we got a kill. That's pretty good. There we go. I'm going to jump into Abundance real fast here. The Murden is up in the top lane. There's a medevac actually called down by Morales. Might be able to get it. Yeah, there we go. We're able to actually stop the medevac here. Zagara's going to go down. Lieutenant Morales also going to go down. Good job, team. We finally get our level 10. Level 10 here. There's a couple things you can do. You can go for bunker drop or combustion. Bunker drop is the one that you just saw that the enemy team's Blaze had, where basically you can call out a bunker and everyone gets armor and you're protected in a team fight, that sort of thing. Or combustion, which is a charged ability that does a huge amount of AoE damage. I'm going to go for combustion. That one seems like fun. I don't think we're really going to need to use... We're not going to need to utilize a bunker drop, I don't think, right now. Just want to try it out. Because, like, bunker drop seems like it's pretty... That seems pretty self-explanatory, you know? Like, you drop down a safe place for your team to get out of a bad team fight or situation, and it protects everything. But I want to see what combustion does. I remember looking at it on the video, and it looked pretty darn neat. There's a drag there by Lieutenant Morales... not Lieutenant Morales, but by the Haka. I'm actually going to go after Blaze here. Here comes the combustion. And then I get immediately stunned out of it. All right. Did combustion do even anything? I don't know. Channel for 2 points upon ending slow nearby enemies 60% deals 74% or 74 damage. The damage over time is extended the longer Blaze channels it. Up from 1 second. From 1 second up to 5 seconds. His movement speed is also reduced by 50%, so you don't have to stay stationary for combustion. By the way, I've already finished Grill and Kill. That was like the easiest quest ever. And there's really no excuse for us not to get this this immortal, especially considering the fact that we had just got done beating them in the team fight. I'm just gonna ignore Murd in here. There we go. We got the ignite, but here come the enemy team. They're gonna go for the defense. I'm gonna activate Pyromania here as well. And again, I'm just trying to reduce the amount of damage done by the enemy team. So Murden's not really doing a whole lot of anything to me right now. Unfortunately, down goes Nazeba, or not Nazeba, but the Haka. We were able to get the immortal, which is good. I'm glad I didn't have to be too sad about that. We're going to activate combustion, and once again, I get stuck in Nazeba's zombie wall. I'm not sure whose fault that keeps on happening is. Gonna back on out of here, and I'm just gonna go ahead and hearth. So we were able to get the immortal, but it's already pretty much dead, as to be expected going up against Sergeant Hammer and Zagara. So, but hey, look at that, we got a gate and two turrets. It's pretty good. We even got a turret down in the bot lane. It's a bonus. 11-9 so far in favor of the enemy team. Still, anyway, I'm gonna see if I can help out Kate here. Gonna activate Pyromania, get blown away like 10 miles by Sergeant Hammer. It was a nice attempt there on the drag by Dahaka. And these zombie walls, man. Level 13, let's see, suppressive fire, reduces spell power, reduces attack speed, or fuel leak. Let's just go for full, like, straight up debuff on the enemy team. I like the sound of that. So my oil spill will now slow the attack speed of the enemy team's heroes. Gonna activate the shield here. I'm waiting for Pyromania to come up. So everyone just needs to get away from the bunker. There's no reason to feed into it. Then we can go back in there. I do have combustion ready to go. There's the channel here by myself going with combustion. And Blaze is having a tough time getting out of that. Gonna activate Pyromania as well, just so I can get a little bit of extra damage out. Unfortunately, I was not able to get the abundance healing there from Kate. Kate needs to be real careful here. Kate needs to be real careful. I was able to stop Zagara. Might be able to get Sergeant, or not Sergeant Hammer, but Lieutenant Morales. She is gonna live barely. So the Immortal's coming up in 1 second here. I was just making sure that Kate was going to be safe here. Everyone's going to be hearthing. There's a big, kind of a big wave pushing down the bot lane. We're going to have to take care of that. Nazeebo, going to help Nazeebo do that. I don't want him getting distracted because we need to get this Immortal. There you go. So as you can see, you can change the direction of the oil slick. It doesn't have to be straight in front of Blaze. You can go horizontal if you want to. That being said, it is still pretty wonky. Oh, Nova, what are you doing? What are you doing, Nova? You know, showing you a little bit of the peeling power of Blaze here. Gonna take this abundance here from Kate. There we go, and I get the combustion out, and that instantly stops the bunker of the enemy team's Blaze. I'm gonna activate Pyromania as well. We're just gonna keep on debuffing the enemy team. Getting into the thick of it here. Blaze is gonna try to take on three of us with Kate healing. I don't think that's gonna work out too well. I'm gonna stun Murden here and see if I can help out the Haka. Big time maul there by Zagara, but we were able to get out of that. Almost called it Maul of the Void. I'm playing Isaac all of a sudden. There we go, able to stop Blaze also. We need to make sure that we stay on top of Lieutenant Morales. Good job by Kate using Cleansing Flame, staying on top of her as well. Morales tries to run into the medevac. She was able to get away just barely. Meanwhile, Nazebo is fine. We're starting to work on the enemy team's hero. By hero, I mean immortal. Somehow that didn't ignite it. I'm not sure how that works. There we go. Good healing by Kate so far. I believe this is only her second game as Alexstrasza. Alexstrasza is not exactly that hard, or not that easy to play. Kate gonna go Dragon Queen form here. I know Sergeant Hammer's ploy over here. Unfortunately, I'm out of mana though. I get stunned by Murden. Nazebo went back. I really, really need mana. Really, really need mana badly. I do have Pyromania active right now, so I'm reducing the amount of damage that all of them are doing, which I sort of like. I like this whole debuff thing going on. Haka's gonna get taken down. There's a big time Raging Spirit by Nazebo. Unfortunately, I still don't have enough mana for the charge. And we're just going to have to back on out of here. Let's see. Level 16, Jet Propulsion hits, grant armor, reduce cooldown, heals for damage dealt. Spell armor, Juggernaut plating. Let's go for a heal. Let's go for heat treatment. I like that. Yeah, so unfortunately, even though all of us were trying to stop the Immortal, we were not able to deal with the longevity and the amount of damage done by Sergeant Hammer's basic attacks here. I don't know how I'm number one in siege damage. With Nazebo should be just destroying it. Dertaka's died six times. I guess there's Zagara's also died six times. Alright, anyway. We need to take down Lieutenant Morales. We also need to make sure this doesn't happen. Okay. Apparently Sergeant Hammer's concussive blast can just shoot you like 500 miles away. Pretty neat. We're actually going to go in the back line and completely miss Lieutenant Morales. But I've got combustion activated. There's a huge, huge bomb by myself. You saw that big. It was almost like Zul's Poison Nova in a way. Completely whiffed there on the jet propulsion. Able to get the I'm able to get the slow there on Blaze, but I'm trying to get into the back line against Lieutenant Morales because that's what we've got to do. Going to get Maul. We're going to get mauled there by Zagara. The enemy team's Immortal still doing a lot of damage to us here in the keep. I'm going to activate my shield. Should be able to get Sergeant Hammer. There we go. Able to take her out. But again, the Immortal is on our core right now. We've got to do something against that. Because the Immortal can very easily end the game. I don't know if my team is actually aware of this or not. But we gave up a lot of free damage on the core. Or basically nothing, so. And Lieutenant Morales is going to get taken down, so good job by Kate and Nova. Alright. And we're still looking for our first fort. Alright. Hey, we've taken down two of the turrets and the gate up top. That's pretty good. Pretty happy about that. I'm definitely liking the combo mechanic of the oil slick plus the flame stream. And I also sort of like the idea of Blaze getting to the middle of everybody and just debuffing the heck out of them to where they can't do a lot of damage. They also can't get away from them. And on top of that, if you pop Pyromania inside of that, you're gonna be able to heal yourself. But what I'm doing right now is just soaking up the lane and just trying to get us. some sort of advantage here for the next team fight. We have the, we've got the, I feel that we have the stronger of the two team fights. With Alex Straza and especially with Nazebo going Rampaging Spirits. Definitely want to go over here. I'm not sure if the medevac is coming up top here or not. I didn't actually mean to charge, but that's all right. Yeah, we gotta definitely be careful about Zagara and everyone going after the core. Yeah, they're definitely gonna try to backdoor it. So the enemy team taking a pretty big risk here. And we're gonna hopefully punish them for it. I'm gonna activate Combustion. And there's a big time slow. I end up getting mod, but not before I was able to get Combustion off. No, that's the wrong way, Daka. There we go, take him down. The enemy team still has Zagara now trying to take down the core. At least I thought she was, but no. She's going to get taken down. The enemy team going a little bit too hard there. We got to stop this catapult first, though. Catapults can still very easily end the game. So level 20, let's see what we got. We've got Flash Fire. It slows and also removes the movement speed penalty, or the basic attack slows deal damage over time. I sort of like Flash Fire. That sounds pretty darn good. We need to push for the win with this Immortal is about the only way that we can win this game. Especially with the enemy team being completely down. We've got those camps that we got earlier going over the top side. And hopefully taking out that keep. So this Immortal is going to go down to the bot lane here. And we're going to have 100% Immortal here, which is going to be very, very difficult for the enemy team to deal with. Well, I take that back. They've got Sergeant Hammer and Zagara on the same team. They're going to be able to handle that pretty easily, especially considering the fact we've not taken down the bottom gate. So here we go. Going to make sure we take down the creep tumors of Zagara. I'm going to be keeping an eye on where Zagara ends up going here, because you know they're going to be going. They may be going straight for the core here with this dropship. We'll have to wait and find out. Remember, we are going up against a hard 5-stack. No, they decided not to go up there. There we go, so I activate Combustion here, and I'm going to get the slow and the big-time damage. I'm going to also activate Pyromania. Now remember, I'm debuffing and healing myself on top of dealing lots of damage to the enemy team. Enemy team in a lot of trouble, able to get the stun on Lieutenant Morales. The Maw is not able. I don't know where the Maw went. I heard it go off, but it wasn't anywhere near me. Kate's going to go ahead and use Dragon Queen here. We've already taken down Sergeant Hammer. Now Murden in a lot of trouble. Able to get the stun on Murden along with the drag. Murden's going to just barely survive. I thought I could get him with a flame stream. We still have our Immortal doing damage. There's the Maw that time around. I guess I didn't hear the Maw earlier. Gonna go ahead and stun Zagara here, doing lots of damage here with with Nazebo. Down she goes. It's down to the enemy team's 3-stack now. We need to take down Lieutenant Morales and just keep her out of the way. I'm able to get the stun there on Morales. I used Pyromania as well. She's gonna activate the medevac, which went, I think, a grand total of 2 feet. The enemy team now has we were on the core. They got too overconfident trying to end the game. Thought they could do it. It's not going to happen. And we're going to turn this one around for an epic comeback, showing you the capabilities of Blaze here. Going to go ahead and activate Combustion here. I'm going to die, but I don't think it matters. Final total, 27-15, 111,000 damage tank. Good lord, 98,000 siege damage as well. Good job by Kate, 88,000 healing. MVP is going to go to Nazebo. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll put a link down below to Kate's channel. And also, make sure you tell me what your favorite builds are so far for the brand new hero, Blaze. And keep an eye out for more Heroes of the Storm content. If you want to subscribe, get notified so when my new videos go live, of course, you get notified wherever you consume this video. Until next time, so long, everybody! Woo!